What's going down, people? I'm Jared Bronstein, and welcome to In From Overload. If you want to connect with me, check out my personal YouTube channel, youtube.com/JaredBronstein. It's my name, with two R's, so spell it right. And you can follow me on Snapchat, Instagram, or Twitter at Bron7, or don't. Whatever you want. One thing is for sure, you shouldn't let your pet snake get stuck in your earlobe because, well, that hurt a lot. And you'd end up in the emergency room, and it'd be really awkward explaining how you got a snake in your earlobe. And that's actually the case for Ashley Glaw of Portland, Oregon. I always want to call it Oregon, but I know it's not Oregon. It's Oregon, which is really weird. Kind of sounds like Oregon. She uploaded a picture of her sitting in a hospital room with the caption, "Current situation, I was holding my hashtag snake and saw his hashtag dumb, saw a hole which just so happened to be my earlobe, and thought that it would be a bright idea to attempt to make it through. It all happened so fast that before I even knew what was going on, it was already too late. Now, believe it or not, I'm sitting here in the emergency room with Bart stuck in my ear. Just my luck, oh snake stuck in ear, snake stuck in earlobe, gouged ears, snakes like gouged ears." Well, that sucks. The Facebook post has been shared just under 33,000 times at the time of this recording, and as you can imagine, almost every news site covered the story, including the Metro, obviously Us, Bro Bible, Unilad, you name it, they probably covered it. Thankfully, the story comes to a positive end, as the doctors just had to make a small incision in Ashley's ear, stick some Vaseline in there, and good old Bart slid right out. Bart is the snake's name, in case you guys didn't pick up on that. But still, it'd be pretty scary for both Ashley and Bart. Here you have this poor little snake who has no idea what's going on. I'm actually surprised it didn't try to bite Ashley just out of distress. And imagine if you were Ashley and had a snake literally inches away from your face. I mean, I don't necessarily hate snakes, but I'm not the biggest fan. My brother has some snakes, so I've like pet a snake before and it's crawled on me, but I don't know, I just don't really trust them. They're untrustworthy. Like a snake, yo. You're a snake. Mines are a snake. And I'm happy the story ended without anyone or anything dying. More specifically, I'm happy to report both Ashley and Bart will make a full recovery. As always, you gotta let me know in the comments down below what you would do put in that situation. And although some sites are claiming she purposely let her snake go through her earlobe, she made it clear it was an accident, which I believe, because why would you purposely let a snake go through your earlobe? That doesn't make sense. Either way, comment your thoughts right down below. But now, in the video we did about the baby dolphin who died after tourists wanted selfies with it, Erica Stones said, "We are the animals, not the animals. We are two Twitter, Facebook, and many other social media phones have made us evil." I think I know what you're trying to say, but that was not English. Dante Singh said, "Jared, I love your vids on IO and your channel." Dante, my man. That's a little props to you. It's probably awkward because it's to a camera. Thank you. And you guys should check out my channel if you haven't already, because Dante likes it, bro. Dark Wolf said, "You look exactly like my drug dealer, but just a few years older." All right, I don't know, is that a compliment? I really don't know. I hope he doesn't look like a deadbeat, because then you're saying that I look like a deadbeat. If your drug dealer is a successful guy, then thank you. Anyways, guys, that finishes this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Share with friends, like, subscribe. I'll see you soon.